Hi guys, welcome to Mage with me, Sid, on the Mage server, and I've done a fair little bit of pieces around the place, not much down here, but I have, we're trying to get a gate network running up on between spawn and here, so people can visit people's places easier, and so I have built a Ars Magica gate system up here. We've got put a whole load of vines in as well around the place. So this is things, got a few plants. Got the garden going and it's nice and rough. So here is our gate system. I've done this kind of little eye-like design, which if I could get up something suitably high, like a tree that I'd built, we can get possibly a better view, or possibly not. Yeah, so we've got the gate there. Now, you can travel. My runic key is purple. We've found real problems with these gates on the server. Say hello. Basically, we've not been able to get the damn things working with reasonable combinations. So I have... Chris has been doing a lot of research with Ellie. Eliarch, and they have discovered that it works with a single runic key, a single thing. So I picked purple because it's my favourite colour, and if anybody wants it, duff, it's mine. tree hasn't really changed much, just roughened it up around the area. We've got obviously that going on around here. I'm not going to start with the tree today. I may do a little bit of work later on it, but I have something I've been wanting to do for a while. So we are going to go and make a few odds and sods, a few thingies, a few spoddly-doos. So first thing I'm going to need is I'm going to need to get some wheat, because I'm going to need to breed my cattle a bit, so we'll take a stack with us down, and I need to make a golden lasso, which is string, nuggets, and ender pearls. I'm going to need a couple of those, I think. I don't know whether I've got any... Oop, bit of lag. Are we crashing? We're crashing. No, we're not crashing, we're back. December 2nd. Yes, looking forward to that big time. Right, so that's got my villager in it. That one's empty, so I need another. So I'm going to need a bit of gold. A bit of gold nuggies going on. And some, what was it? String and an ender pearl. Should have plenty of ender pearls kicking around, because they ain't a problem now. Two should be enough, I think. Right. I didn't pick the string up, did I? 1, 2, 3, 4. Bang. So there is, in Lycan's mobs, there are a number of mounts. As you know, we've already got the Uvaraptor. I haven't done a Ventoraptor yet, although that is on my hit list of things. Oh, I already had some nuggets. Oh well. Right. So, yeah, and one of those mounts you can get is a pinky. Oh, night time. Let me just go and see whether everybody's feeling sleepy or not. Now, pinkies, they're not particularly fast. They are quite tough. We have 80 hit points when they're fully functional, shall we say, and they have a special ability, and they are quite aggressive, and they are incredibly difficult to tame. The reason being is because, in fact, I need to go and grab something out of my storeroom while I remember, as soon as we've got one more person snoozing. Good. The reason being is the Ventoraptors eat cooked concipede meat easy. The Uvaraptors eat cooked concipede meat. Ventoraptors cooked maca meat. These guys you tame five, I think. these guys you tame with hellfire charges. And hellfire charges you only get from killing beer moths in the nether. So I've killed a few with my old sword. And I think that's got, he's got looting 3, which gives me a much better drop rate. But you still have to get, you can't tame an adult pinky. Adult pinkies are too aggressive. So what I'm going to need to do is find a suitable spot somewhere out the way. And I'm going to have to clear a bit of jungle, I think, to do this, which is a shame. I don't like wrecking terrain, but we'll kind of hide it back here, I think. And actually, we'll change that to feather touch. And while we're at it, we can get some more leaves for the tree, which is always a bonus. So I need to make a pinky breeding pit. I've got a pinky spawner that we got on the last live stream from, well, not the last live stream, because I'm now, this is 2 and a bit weeks ahead, because I'm getting ready for my holiday, which is on December the 2nd, as you probably saw from the chat. And we're not quite in December yet. As I say, I'm recording a full 2 weeks ahead at the moment. So, yes, we're definitely going to have continuity errors. But I got a pinky spawner, so we can get pinkies. That is not a problem. And we can kill pinkies because, you know, we've got a good sword. But I do need to make some space for these. So I'm going to make myself a little breeding pit, and I will be right back with you. Okay, I've dug a pit. This is spawning room dimensions, 9x9. We can come down here and place the spawner in there, no problem. I have no idea. But what we need now is we need some moo cows. So let us just pop in here and let me just divest myself of some of that. Come on then, my lovelies. Come on, everybody have a breed, that's right. Come on, get fruity. Everybody get fruity. Anybody else? No, I think we're done. And then we need these. Oh, you'll do. And you'll do. Okay. And the last thing we're going to need is the spawner, which, if we're lucky, will not have a sleep through tonight. And because, of course, this is light dependent. It's a spawner. It's going to have spawning rules just like any other spawner. And I would imagine that one of those will be light levels. So, what we have to do, well, for starters, we probably want to just illuminate up around the place just a little bit. Make sure we don't get any unwelcome visitors, but that should still be dark enough in there. Right, where is my diamond dolly? Oh, God. Don't drop that in there. So, we're going to place that there, and we are going to hightail it out. Maybe, just for good measure, zap some of that out. In fact, we'll zap the whole thing off. Now, with a bit of luck, in a moment, we'll get some pinkies spawning. Hello, pinkies. Yeah, they are ferocious as hell. But, oh, I don't believe I just dropped that in there. Anyway, fortunately, I've got these with me. So, drop one, drop two, and we should have a nice baby pinky. So we can shoot that. We need to kill some of these adult ones. Which might take a while. Thank you. And you should be... Yeah, there's a baby. And then if we get the Hellfire charges, we should be able to just dig down a little here. We should be able... Oh, I can tame two, but I don't want to tame two. I only want to tame one. Just get rid of him. Oh, bloody hell. Got me a good crack there. And we have a pet Pinky. Now, at the moment, he's pretty useless because he's a baby. We can't do anything with him. But if we leave him in here, he'll grow up big and strong. So that's what we're going to do. We'll let him. We'll leave him in there for now. Let him grow up, and I'll be back with you once he's a big boy. Okay. Well, we're waiting for Junior to mature. I say waiting. He may have done. I've just harvested the tree farm, but he's going to need his own stable because he's an aggressive little bugger, and you wouldn't want to put him in with any other critters. Let's go and have a look, see how big and strong he is now. You're still a baby. Oh no, you are an adult. Let me get on and get you somewhere to live, Bill. So I'm going to build him a little stable area, similar to we did with the older Uber Raptor with Errol, as his name tag completely failed to take. I think here. Let's take this tree out of the equation. There we go, that's out. So we need to clear a little space for him. The other thing is I don't want these things too close to me because of that damn noise. Let me just check my volume. No, it's way down. Well, it's a normal volume, I should say, for me. So anyway, we'll clear this out. Now, this is not going to be anything special, no wonderful mega builds or anything coming along. But as before, we definitely want a 4-high entrance. So let's do that about here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we're going to need to be, probably want to be 3 wide again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And because that, I hate... When I build, I hate to be able to see the blocks at the edge. It's just a little pet hate of mine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And last but not least, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I'm just going with a spruce wood border, and then we're going to mix up the edge a little bit with some of this. But let's start off how we mean to go on. Starters, we're going to have this kind of thing going on up top, I think. For no particular reason, I just want to vary the textures that we've got going on around here. And then we'll do that and that there. That should do for that. And then down here, we're going to kind of mix and match a little bit of this action. Mix it up. Until we've got pretty much a full house. And You can do, you know, building's one of those things that is such a subjective. You get a lot of people go, oh, this is the correct way to build, and you know, the old really detailed, in-depth, in-out walls where you've got upside-down steps and steps, and sometimes they just look far too fussy. Sometimes you want something simple. So, yeah, we're going for simples. That's our aim today. Now, I'm going to go with the jungle wood roof again because I've got loads of jungle wood and it does kind of fit the biome I'm in. Another thing I do like to do when I'm building, wherever possible, it's not always possible, is... Oh, I didn't bring slabs, damn it. Oh well, I'll soon make a crafting bench. Is to, when you're building, look at your surroundings. So we've got a spruce forest over there, we're in a jungle forest, we've got a little bit of a swamp over there, so we've got a good range of the three woods, but we don't really have much birch. So typically when people would build, and certainly in, you know, prehistory times, I suppose, they would build with the materials that were commonly on hand. I mean, obviously there's exceptions to every rule, you know, the stones that were used in Stonehenge, for example, come from nowhere near Stonehenge. I think they had to transport them several hundred miles, those things, which is like one of the main wonders of that particular historical site in the UK, is the fact, not so much that it was so massively, whoppingly huge. I'll just take you out like that for now. And I'll probably do an overlap one down the sides as well, just to keep in keeping with what we've done previously. Oh god, you're gonna make life awkward for me, aren't you, you damn things? Yes, you are. And if I do that, oh no, it went, that's all right, I'll let it off. And obviously we go, oh, there. Nothing overly fancy going on, but, you know, just to get somewhere for him to live when he's stabled in with us. Like that, and well, I better eat, I suppose. It's always... Oh. Stop raining. Still one of my favourite spells I've ever built, that one. It's like, go away rain, we don't want you. Ugh. Hup. And... there. Like that. Now I need a crafting bench. Let's just knock that together. Oh god. Quickly, pop it there, and we'll do a couple of sets of slabs. Hup, hup. So that will go on here and here. Now, one thing trick I've used in the past is, now I'm not going to leave those there, that is just a support for that, and it just gives a little detail to the roof, a little peak at either end, which kind of works nicely, doesn't it? You have to use slabs to do that. You can do it with any old block just to get the support in. Well, of course, except of course when you stood on the bottom half of a slab, then you have to do that kind of thing. But, and then maybe the other thing we could do down here, which often works quite well, is do upside down, bang, and no, No, that's not right. Hang on. That's not right either. Have I got any dirt on me? I have. Just make up some fences. Oh crap. Right. Let's just dirt pole up. And again, this is just all about detail. Strictly speaking, completely non-functional detail as well. So, you know, absolutely unnecessary in any way, shape, or form. But yeah, that looks kind of nice. Can we get something similar going on like that at the back? Probably, if we get careful with this. No, that's not right, is it? How are we gonna place that like that? That's gonna have to do without one. This is gonna be interesting. I know. Change my mode. Grab some of this. And then we can place you. All right. And you. Something not right there, and it's bugging me. Let me just double check what I've done wrong. Yeah, I knew I got it the wrong way around. You know when you're looking at it and you can just see the problem without even having to try and look really what it was. It was one of those feelings that you get when you do that, and that worked okay. Get rid of you. Pick up that. We can stick a little bit of dirt in there. We can put some of this back. In fact, that'll save me a fence. That's what I was looking for, the word. Me and words, they don't go well. Yeah, so this is just, as I say, completely unnecessary level of detail, really. That should give me two, shouldn't it? I don't think that's enough. I'm not sure what's... Oh, them chickens. Alright. Okay, so we should be able to finish this off fairly quickly now and get back to some other stuff. Okay, and let me do the final thing, which is F7, check it's spawnable. Oh, there's a spawnable area there that I've not noticed. Not anymore. And this should all be good. So all we need to do then is do the... Oops. Go away. And grab some of that. Well, that's not what I want. Interesting. What's going on here? Let's re-chisel that to large dirt bricks. There we go. We'll take that out. We'll just have a couple protruding out like this as well. And Let me just go and empty my inventory over here. A little bit. Let's leave you and you and you and you and you. Oh, turn the F7 back off. I know that's spawnable, but it's only temporary. And again, same trick here. Bonk, bonk, bonk. Fence, fence. Gate, gate, gate. Right, let's go and get Pinky. I don't think I'm going to give him a name. He is Pinky. One of my favourite old cartoons. Well, not old, it's quite new. Pinky and the Brain. I just used to love that cartoon. What are we going to do today, Brain? Same as we always do, Pinky. Try to take over the world. Hey! Right. Let me... Right. Click Q. We're going to give you a saddle. We're going to give you some diamond armor. And we're going to give you some inventory. We're also going to feed you a bit because you're... There, you see. It was hungry. We'll dig out that way. And come on then. Let's take him for a spin. Whoop. Ow. That's going to be a problem. This is quite. Hopefully, this pen is. Yeah, that's large enough. Right, where shall we go? Let's get rid of that for starters. So this guy, when anything attacks you, he will attack it back. He is highly aggressive. That's when he's not stuck in a water flow anyway. And his special ability, in the same way as you could press F to make the things... Who's on? Ellie. Ellie's fairly close. Yeah, the same way as you can use the flap ability on the Uvaraptor and the jump forward ability on the Ventoraptor, which I think we've mentioned, but... obviously, I've not got a Ventor yet, so... that's, you know, not demonstrated that. This guy has a special ability as well, and it is roar. And when he roars, he poisons things. Come here, piggy. Well, I don't blame him. He's behind him. Why are you getting all fruity? Oh, I don't know. So yeah, he's quite a tough little bugger. Let's try it on this one. He can't get away easily. You think he can't get away easy anyway. I think he wants to mate with it. So yeah, this is the Pinky. We'll go and scare the crap out of someone with him, shall we? Let me just put that away. Right. Doo-doo-doo. Please don't bother me, any of you guys. But yeah, different mount. Now, as I said, one of my... ideas. Oh, finally a mount that didn't tip you off the moment he gets wet. Oh, that's a novelty. Always, he'd love to be let loose in this lot, wouldn't he? Oh, I just received a new message. Well, I will have to have a look at that message when I'm not on screen. So yeah, we are chugging along, and we're just going to go. But the just having a mount that doesn't spaz out in water like horses do in normal Minecraft is a major bonus. Jesus, this is going to be fun. Of course, the big problem with something this size is getting him through heavily wooded areas like this without killing me. Right, well, I'm going to continue over and go and visit somebody, and I will see you when we get there. Yep, it wasn't him, but he's turned up because I told him I'd got my new toy to show him. Yeah, anyway, I should be talking, actually. I just realised I'm recording. He's actually a pretty cool man. Oh, dear. So anyway, that's the that's Pinky. I'm gonna call him Pinky. dear. Anyway, let me just dismount for a second here and hitch him up. So while we're here, we might as well have a quick tour of Ellie and Never blah, 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 blah. This place. This is coming along well. It's huge, huge. Oh. Ooh, nice. Nice chandelier. I've got no idea how you spell that. Yeah, this is starting to look really nice. Whoa. Beacon. Is that a beacon? I don't know what the hell caused that. But yeah, I think when we came here last time, I said this started. Oh, here we go. Here the little fella's working. Well, the golems are doing all the harvesting for him, so that's the way to harvest magical crops. So just sit and watch them all day. I better not bring Pinky near that. Pardon me. Anyway, I realise I'm kind of going over a little bit here. So we'll have a quick peek around, see what else we got. Oh yeah. Whoa. What am I hitting that keeps speeding me up? I mean, I would have said beacon, but... Oh, that's nice. Oh, it's under the... Ah, clever. Yeah, so smeltery. That's quite a nice effect using the carpenter's blocks, I must say. blood magic early doors. Let's go down here and use the speed. And yeah, this is looking really, really nice. Everything to a room and a room for its. This is looking good as well, actually. So, a bit of thorny craft. What you got over here? More Thorncraft. Need some flooring. Is the witchery area still as advanced? Let's go have a look. Wow. This is really a huge and impressive building. As I say, I'm not sure whether I mentioned it before, but this was originally all cobble, and this has been one. Yay! Oh no, we moved on. Moved on a bit. Three stoves. There's one stove here before. What's Alex dropped off? Distillery, altar, spinning wheel. Yeah, Alex is the server witch. The littlest witch. Oh dear. Anyway, guys, well, not done a great deal magic wise. We have managed to get our pet Pinky this thing, and we've not done anything to the tree, which is a nice change. But yeah. And we've been around to. Ellie's base, Ellie never. I gave her a starter thing. mail order witch kit. But yeah, thanks for watching. I'm sorry, I'm getting a bit distracted here by all the shiny stuff. Hydrangeas, and. What looks to be... Whoa, that is a lot of mana. How many hydrangeas are you running per? 4 per... source. Oh, okay. Anyway, sorry, I'm getting distracted again. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you next time. So, until then, bye for now.